Hello, and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today, I'll be reading History of Durpar and Var the Golden, which I found in a commoner's house in Baragost. History of Durpar and Var the Golden. Durpar and Var the Golden share a common history. Over 3,000 years ago, these countries were both subject to the great kingdom of Rauran. When Rauran fell in -2488 DR, the countries of Durpar and Var barely survived the destruction. Rioting, mass destruction, and hatred of nobility were rampant, and the two countries descended into barbarism for over two millennia. Finally, after most of the barbarian tribes were wiped out by the great empire of Molarand, a leader emerged. Satama, a mere trader, experienced a divine revelation and formulated a new philosophy. All things in the world were connected, were part of a single creation spirit, and all of the gods of the realms were merely parts of the same entity. Soon all the Shining Lands embraced the teachings of Satama, and the seeds of civilization were laid in what came to be known as the Lands of the One. Since the Lands of the One had many natural resources, trade with Molarand and Lurin became a way of life. Merchants were honored above all. In time, the Maharaja of Durpar and the Raja of Var were replaced with a council of merchants. During this time, the land suffered occasional raiding attacks from the horsewomen of Dambrath, and had many skirmishes with the neighboring countries of Estigund and Ulgarth. In 1023 DR, after an armed peace had been worked out with Ulgarth, the council of merchants decided that something needed to be done about the raiders from Estigund who were hurting trade with other countries. War was an inconvenience, but interrupting trade was life-threatening. Geradim, the richest merchant in the lands, was given power to negotiate a settlement. During these negotiations he proved, at least in the eyes of the Durparians, that he was indeed the master trader he seemed. Estigund had just tried a foolish invasion of Dambrath. The vengeful female leaders of that land wiped out nearly every able-bodied fighting man they sent. The monsters of Veldorn were causing problems, and Estigund was going through a famine. It was here that Geradim showed his fine merchant's instincts. He could not pass up such an advantage, and he began bargaining the most outrageous trade of all time. He met with the leaders of Estigund, a fearful king and his nobles, and explained the advantages of Durparian life and the philosophy of the Adama, the oneness of all things. He bargained for days, and finally the king made the trade. He purchased the whole of Estigund for the countries of Durpar and Var at the price of 24 gems. He also promised protection and help for their integration into the Durparian way of life. Thus were formed the Shining Lands. Within 100 years, the three countries shared a common way of life, and with the added strength and resources of Estigund, Durparian merchants increased their trading range. They roamed as far east as Karatur, as far north as the Sea of Fallen Stars, and west to Dambrath and Halrua. At the present time, with the newly discovered lands of Mastika and Zakara beckoning, the future looks bright. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate, History of Durpar and Var the Golden.